Recognize the leader of the third party.
Monsieur le Président, on dirait que le ministre de la Santé et le Premier ministre ne font ni l'une ni l'autre confiance aux régies régionales de santé pour faire leur travail. Je n'apprends rien à personne en disant que le vieillissement de la population rend notre système de soins de santé plus vulnérable. Cependant, le ministre n'a pas encore expliqué pourquoi il enlève aux régies régionales de santé la gestion du système extramural pour le confier à Medevie. Pourquoi le ministre de la Santé ne fait-il pas confiance à ses propres employés pour établir une bonne relation de travail entre les professionnels de l'extramural et les paramédics?
Honorable Premier.
Monsieur le Président, nous voulons travailler avec les régies de la santé ici dans la province, mais il faut être très clair que nous, comme gouvernement, nous voulons mettre de l'avant les guides, les lignes directrices pour comment on va délivrer un système de soins de santé qui est de haute qualité dans toutes les régions de la province. Et Monsieur le Président, c'est très clair que notre gouvernement pense que c'est important d'avoir des services dans notre système de soins de santé dans les régions rurales de notre province. So no, Mr. Speaker, we're not just going to blindly allow the health authorities to do everything that they want if it goes against the very clear direction that we have given. And in this case, it was very clear when the former CEO of Horizon was suggesting we close rural hospitals, we said no, Mr. Speaker. It is very clear when Vitalité is trying to cut services in rural hospitals, we have said no. We will work with them to figure it out, Mr. Speaker, but there is a balance to be struck between ensuring that they do what they need to do on operations, but that it follows the big picture that we have to make healthcare top-notch here in this province.
Leader of the third party.
Mr. Speaker, perhaps the problem with creating linkages between the extramural nurses and other health professionals managed by the regional health authorities and the paramedics is the private management of those paramedics. The Telegraph Journal has reported that Ambulance New Brunswick has sought permission from the Integrity Commissioner to ignore its right to information request for information concerning the frequency with which ambulances are taken off the road due to staffing shortages, something that concerns all New Brunswickers, Mr. Speaker. At the same time, it says, in fact, it doesn't even have that information because it's held in secret by its private Medevie managers. Mr. Speaker, with our extramural health services going to private management, when those services decline under that private management, will the minister also defend the shroud of secrecy that will descend around them?
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Merci beaucoup pour la question. Évidemment, nous prenons, je répète ce que j'ai dit plusieurs fois dans cette chambre, nous prenons très, très, très au sérieux tout ce qui concerne l'accès à l'information de côté de cette chambre. Et nous sommes là pour respecter la loi et nous sommes prêts à collaborer avec quiconque fait des demandes. Et c'est pas, le ministère de la Santé n'y fait pas exception. The RTI Act is there to determine what information should be released and what information should be protected. That always requires interpretation by the body that has the data. And in this case, the commissioner, the privacy commissioner, is there to serve as that role. That is an independent body out of the Legislative Assembly, and we will fully respect their interpretation, and we will comply to what they ask us to do, because, again, for us, right to information is our government's top priority.
Leader of the third party.
Well, Mr. Speaker, from what I can see, secrecy abounds everywhere. The president of Ambulance New Brunswick, in his role as also the president of Medevie's subsidiary, MBEMS, refused to release the company's audited financial statements to the Crown Corporation's committee. In fact, he doesn't even provide those audited financial statements to the board of Ambulance New Brunswick. This Medevie subsidiary received over $2 million in performance bonuses last year for underspending at Ambulance New Brunswick. Under the new contract for managing the extramural program, this Medevie company will earn up to an additional $1.8 million annually in performance bonuses for a total of close to $4 million in performance bonuses. Can the Minister of Health tell us why that money wouldn't be better spent by the regional health authorities to integrate paramedics with the extramural care under their management?
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Well, that answer, Mr. Speaker, is quite simple. The ambulance system has never been a public system. It has always been managed by private organizations, and that has been the fact for always, except when it became Ambulance New Brunswick about 10 years ago, then it became a Part 3 public entity. So since then, since Medivie has been managing it, it has been, since then, and only since then, a public entity. So, and since then, we have respected the RTI process. There is a process in place, and that process allows interpretations to be done by all parties. And we certainly want to see as much transparency and accountability as possible, and that's what we're doing. It is also normal that there be some discrepancies between interpretations, and that's why we have the Privacy Commissioner that will look into that, and I can assure the people of this House that we will fully comply with their decisions. Thank you.
Time for question period has expired.